Now, I love checklists in real life. It's helpful to get through a shopping list and completing my work. Check. The reason I love them is checklists break down complex systems into steps in a way that helps even pros avoid mistakes. In this video, I'm gonna share with you 6 best-in-class user onboarding checklists to improve your onboarding experience. Hey friends, it's Randy John from Appcues. If you wanna get the best user onboarding tips and tricks, be sure to smash the subscribe button. Now, a great checklist can not only help new users through your product, but also get them to the aha moment faster and more reliably. So I'm gonna share with you 6 best-in-class examples right now. Number 1 is Evernote's quick win checklist to keep the motivation high. Evernote's onboarding checklist kicks off with a simple, easy to complete task. Create a new note. Within seconds of launching the app, users can click a single button and tick off a first step in the onboarding process, unlocking the feel-good factor that comes from a job well done. But this quick win does more than offer a rush of dopamine. It also builds on the psychological principle of commitment and consistency. When we commit to a course of action, we become psychologically invested in seeing our decision through the end. Evernote's checklist sucks us in with a quick and simple first step, and in doing so, gives us an incentive to continue with the setup process. Now, a quick win checklist is best used by products with a simple and easy to reach aha moment. Number 2 is a partially completed checklist to drive future adoption by Asana. Now, getting users to explore and adopt new features is an important part of creating product stickiness and improving retention. But it's easier said than done. To motivate more users to adopt the feature, Asana uses a punchy onboarding checklist that opens up with the first task already marked off as complete. Since the list of to-dos is short, that incompleteness is motivating rather than discouraging. That's because Asana's checklist harnesses the principle of Zeigarnik effect, which states objectives left incomplete will overwhelm a person's thought over time and drive them to complete them. If you've ever ended in an episode or book chapter on a cliffhanger, you know the feeling all too well. Just like viewers that click on next episode or the reader that turns the page, users want to see a checklist finish. Partially completed to-do lists are best used by products that require a lot of small tasks to get set up. Number 3 is a subtle checklist that lets users go at their own pace. Tandem is a language exchange app that lets users practice language skills with native speakers. The app opts for a more subtle approach to onboarding checklists. Tandem uses a progress bar just above the navigation bar to alert new users to the fact that they have unfinished tasks, but that the finish line is in sight. Tandem's approach to the classic onboarding checklist is effective because it lets users drive the pace at which they explore the app's various features without letting important tasks fall by the wayside. A subtle checklist is best used by apps that have onboarding tasks that are non-essential for functionality, but still important to getting users to experience maximum value with the product. Number 4 is a network effect checklist that kickstarts engagement. Network effect happens when one team member invites someone else from the same organization or group, usually driven by a pursuit of productivity or efficiency. An example of this is growth hackers. They understand that the network effect, which begins by inviting and interacting with other users, can drive up adoption and retention within a product. The user onboarding checklist to kickstart the network effect and get new users active in the growth hackers community as quickly as possible. The milestone set by the checklist centers around connection and contribution. Growth Hackers aims to inspire user engagement by creating connection among like-minded peers and colleagues. A network effect checklist is best used by products with a social element that measures successful user engagement in terms of user interaction, collaboration, and communication. Number 5 is the interactive tutorial checklist for flexible onboarding. Airtable is a powerful tool that's used in thousands of different ways, from managing UX research to categorizing cheeses. But the more flexible a product is, the harder it can be to create a one-size-fits-all onboarding process. Airtable sidesteps the traditional perspective to onboarding processes by using a simple 6-step checklist to launch short visual tutorials. Users are free to engage with each tutorial as much as they like, effectively personalizing the onboarding process to focus only on the parts of the tool that really matches their interests. Each tutorial minimizes down to a color-coded icon with friendly little check marks appearing as users complete each lesson. An interactive tutorial checklist is best used by powerful products with dozens of different use cases that require a flexible, opt-in approach to onboarding. Number 6 is an account checklist that fast-tracks power usage. Acorns is a popular mobile app that lets you automatically invest your spare change. There are at least 8 steps to become a fully activated user. So Acorns created a straightforward onboarding checklist to let users see exactly what's left in the process. The nice thing about this checklist is that it indicates a long-term vision for user success. First threshold, getting your account to $10, is achievable, giving a user a feeling of success before embarking on the more challenging task of getting to $100. But until the goalpost is reached, the prominent progress bar at the top nudges the users to continue on. An account checklist is the best used by products that have high levels of engagement and want to get activated users to become power users. Well, there you have it, 6 best-in-class examples of user onboarding checklists. Which one is your favorite? Or maybe you've seen a better one out in the wild. I'd love to know them in the comments below. I'm always looking for new and better examples. Also, if you found this video valuable, feel free to share it with your colleagues and friends. Share the love and share the knowledge. We've also created a free user onboarding certification course that details how to create an onboarding experience that turns more of your users into happy paying customers. We've got the link below. It's free. Check it out. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get the best tips and tricks to improve your product's user onboarding. We got a bunch of other videos that will really help you improve and boost your product adoption. Well, that's all for now. This is Ramley from Appcues. See you in the next video. Bye.